Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Now, in yesterday's podcast, we went through and copied this data from a web page, and all of the links came in with, of course, the text to display and not the link itself. It'd be really cool if I could get in another column all of the linked locations. So, for example, if I would right-click or just hover, we'll see that this is going to MrExcel.com tip 067.shtml. Or if I right-click and say edit hyperlink, I would actually be able to come here and copy this data. But as you can imagine, it would be very tedious to go through, especially if I had hundreds and hundreds of links, to get the link for each individual one. Well, this is a case where just a few lines of VBA can really solve the problem. I'm going to switch over to the VBA editor, Alt F11, and insert a new module. And I'll create a new subroutine called Get Links. And I'm going to say for each HL, that's my variable for hyperlink, in active sheet dot hyperlinks, next HL. This basically will loop through all of the hyperlinks that are found in the sheet. Now, my problem is I don't use hyperlinks enough, and I really don't remember the properties for hyperlinks. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start to run this in step mode. I'm going to press F8. Now, at this point, the hyperlink variable is enabled. There's something in there, and so I'm going to right-click on it and say Add Watch. Click OK. The watch window pops up, and when I press the plus sign, I get to see all of the properties associated with that variable. For example, hl.address is the link. That's the information I'm really trying to get. Now, the next thing I want to do, though, is figure out where this hyperlink is living. What row is it on? And I don't see anything here that's obviously row 1 or row 2 or something like that. So I'm going to go to parent, and the parent does have, hopefully, yes, a row. So hl.parent.row is going to tell me what row we're on. So now I'm going to go back to my code. I'm going to stop running the code, and we'll say something like cells, which row, and that would be hl.parent.row. What column do I want to write this to? Well, all of my links are in column 1 right now, column A, so I want to write it to column 2. Dot value equals hl.address. Now, we just learned address from the watch window. When I go to the next line, of course, we'll see that address becomes capitalized and parent.row becomes capitalized. That means I didn't type it wrong. And at this point, I think we're good to go. So let me switch back to Excel here. We'll make column A a little bit wider, and I'll run my macro, get links, click run, and there we go. I've solved this problem, taken dozens of links, and actually now have the link over in column B. Now, in tomorrow's podcast, I'll show you how to take this column of links and go out to every single page and pull it into a new workbook in Excel. Great trick. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.